My name is Robin Miles. I am the director for the High Performance for Computing Energy Innovation Program. In this program, national laboratories partner with industry, working with industry to reduce the energy consumption in product and process design. This program is sponsored by the Offices of Energy, Energy Efficiency and Renewable Office, Advanced Manufacturing Office, and Vehicle Technology Office, and the Fossil Energy Office. The national laboratories have the largest computers in the world. We also have the talent that knows how to exploit these computers. We know how to write code efficiently to run on these new architectures, and we have experts in the areas of things like computational fluid dynamics and materials design at the atomistic level through continuum level. We can work with some industries such as steelmaking, chemicals, glass, many high energy users, as well as small innovative companies, to help them reduce energy on the national scale. High-performance computers are actually very useful, especially when it comes to getting accurate physics through the use of multi-scale, multi-physics models. The bigger the computers you have, often the more physics you can put in it and the better resolution that you can add to this. When you have very accurate physics, you can then remove some of the experimental work you do and replace that with computational work. Overall, this should decrease the cost of process and product development. At the extreme is new material discovery, where you really want to work at the very atomistic level all the way up to the continuum level, where material properties are very important for your application. Also, with large computers, you can do many, many, many runs to optimize your product or process design. At the extreme of this is using all those runs, putting in to training a neural net and machine learning so that you can actually produce a reduced order model, which you can then use for product and process optimization in a very fast and cost-effective manner. Using these tools, you're able to develop advanced products in shorter time to market, better quality, and improve your process, better yield, less energy, less material use. The U.S. government appreciates these programs because it helps reduce national energy usage. We have conducted over 100 projects in this program, working with over 40 manufacturers in the United States, from very large sophisticated companies like aerospace companies doing leading-edge work, legacy industries such as steel and glass manufacture, which are high-volume energy users, and innovative small companies in a variety of energy sectors. To engage this program, you engage it through a solicitation process, which we run approximately twice a year. You submit a two-page concept paper, which you can find on our website, the website being hpc4energyinnovation.org. After you submit the concept papers, we review them. Around half of those go forward to the full proposal. At that time, we help select a national laboratory PI for you to work with to write a full proposal. We don't expect industry partners to necessarily know who in the laboratory that they should be talking to or what platforms that they should be using. So by matching you, you can write a really quite good proposal. Then we review the proposal, and then the DOE sponsor looks over the proposals which have been reviewed by the Technical Review Committee and decides which ones to fund. Projects include process optimization. Here's a case where we use process optimization using a neural net machine learning tool. We've done this for many, many different companies. This is the first project that we actually did with Vitro Glass. They had a computational fluid dynamics code that they were using to model their furnace. We did many runs of those so that we can put that into the machine learning neural net, train up the net, and then we could use that for a reduced order model, which ran in 2 minutes instead of the week-long run, which originally was the time it took the computational fluid dynamics program to run. This way, you can do real-time process control by inserting this into your process control, or you can use it for process or product optimization. We do a lot of material design. Here's an example where we're doing material design at the atomistic level. In this case, we're trying to understand the corrosion, the processes for corrosion and corrosion effects. This was at high temperature and very corrosive environments that you might see in, for example, coal plants or jet engines. We also do a lot of material design, for example, in additive manufacturing process, where you're getting microstructure growth. The microstructure, of course, determines the properties of the material, so you want to know that in processes such as additive manufacturing or in welding or some similar processes. If you're interested in engaging in this program, you can learn more on our website, www.hpc4energyinnovation.org. Thank you for listening.